If you create anything from a template in Airtable, you are going to love this video. Here I'm going to be breaking down for you how to build a template in Airtable, and so that you can scale and grow with it over time, I'm going to show you how to deactivate elements in your template so that they're no longer active for new things that you are creating. For our example, we're going to be looking at tasks, but the same concept, the same ideas here can be translated to pretty much any thing that needs a template in Airtable. So if understanding how to create records based on some kind of template is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission here to help you unlock the full potential of no-code tools, starting with Airtable. And in this video, we're going to be breaking down how to use record templates to create multiple different records over time based on different groupings and categories. For our example, as I said, we're going to be using tasks from a task template, but again, you could reinterpret this exact logic for anything that you're working on. But before we get into the heart of the matter, I first want to invite you to join me for some Airtable training. If you're new to Airtable, or if you want a refresher on the basics, grab my free training at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course, and it will be delivered to your email, one video a day for several days to teach you the basic building blocks of Airtable. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen. We are going to start with the back end. So first, we're going to look at our data tables here. I'm going to explain to you how they are connected and why the different components are important. Number two, after that, we're going to build the automation together. And then number three, the most important part of Airtable that is still slept on by so many of our clients, it's all about those interfaces, folks. So we're going to look at interfaces and how you can build templates in your interface to initiate this whole process. So let's go ahead and jump into part one. Here we are in the database. Number one, I've got my projects. And for us, I'm imagining that we've got projects that link to tasks, okay? That's the core component here that's going into play. And I don't have that built just yet on the link, so I better create it. So here's my link from projects to tasks. And again, for our needs, we are going to be creating the tasks automatically for every project based on the template. Now I'm getting a little bit ahead of myself, so let's go table by table. You'll see that projects are linking to groups and tasks. Groups are basically where we're going to tell ourselves what kind of template are we referring to for this. You might have many different task templates, and depending on the group or groups for every project, you're going to want to refer to those tasks. So that's exactly what we're going to be tackling here, and that's why we have groups. So we could select group type 1, type 2, or type 3. We're going to get to that extra stuff in just a moment. Let's look at our tasks table. This is really easy. For our example here, we are just connecting the task to the project. It doesn't even need to connect to the template as you see here. There's no connection here other than directly to projects. Now, what does matter, of course, is the other data that's going to come from our template. So you might have something like a due date. You might have who is this assigned to. But again, I don't want to make it too specific to tasks, because I want you to be able to use this logic for many different use cases in Airtable, not just projects and task management. So for us, all we're going to do is create the new task from our automation with that task name. That's all we care about for our example. Next, we're going to look at groups. Okay. Groups are connecting to projects and they also connect to the task template. So the group is kind of where we say, this is again that the thing that's going to tell us what template we're using for the project. And this will make a little bit more sense later, but let's imagine we had three different types of services that we sold. Each one of these groups could be a different service type. And depending on the service that we sold, of course, we're going to create different tasks for that service because it's going to have a different cost. It's going to include different amounts of work. So we have different tasks depending on the group. And then lastly, we have our templates. So over here in templates, again, really simple. It's linking to groups. So we've got the name of the task. And then we also mark whether it's active or not. And I really like to have some sort of either checkbox or status for different tasks in our template, because it's very common that we're going to make changes to our template over time. And I like to be able to come in and say, you know what, I'm not really deleting task C. I'm just going to mark it inactive, right? I'm taking away the checkbox. And then the next time we create tasks from our template, if it's type 1, the template group type 1, then we're just not going to include tag or task C because it's no longer active. So now that we have the basic understanding, let's move on to part 2 and build our automation. So what's going to trigger it? Well, it's going to be a new project that's connected to a group or groups. And when we have that new project that does not include any tasks, that will trigger our automation because that will basically say, we've got a project, a new one, that is assigned to a group that does not yet have tasks created. So we need our automation to go out there and create those tasks. You could imagine that this project gets created through a form, for example. So that would make sure that every time a new project came in, someone will have chosen already what group or groups are a part of that particular project. So once we have that information, that would all come into existence at the same time that the project was created. That would trigger our automation. So let's get to work. I've assigned some groups here. We're going to flip on over into automations and start building. Now we can, of course, try to build this with Airtable's AI. I haven't had a ton of luck building more robust automation with AI just yet. It seems to run into a bit of a snag. So I'm going to do this by hand, the old fashioned way. So I'm going to say a record matches conditions is my trigger. And if you recall, we mentioned that it was in our projects table. And those conditions are the group is not empty. And let's also say that the name of the project is also not empty, but we will insist that our link to tasks is empty. So if you recall, this is what we just talked through a moment ago on the projects table. And you'll see when we say choose record that we have three different projects that meet that criteria. So we'll go ahead and pick project 3. Any one of them will be sufficient. And now we need to perform a bit of a search, right? We need to find our records here in the task template table. So we're going to find the records in task template and we will perform it based on a condition. So we'll say we're going to go find those records based on the condition that, and right here we'll say what the condition is. We're going to establish that the template groups has any of, and now we're going to click this little gear icon here. Let me actually make this a little bit bigger. So we'll click the gear icon and say dynamic. And now we can come in here and we can say from the record that triggered the automation, we're going to scroll on down to our groups. And we want to say, we want to find stuff that includes the record in our groups. So for us, if you go back to our initial trigger here, what did we have? Our group here in project 3 is type 2. So in our grouping here, when we're searching, we're going to look at our task template for all of the tasks that are associated with group 2. So let's just really quickly test this action step. And here it goes. You'll find that these four different components are found. But wait, I forgot to mention the active level of the tasks. We only want to return those that are active tasks. So let's go ahead and add that condition as well. Active must be checked. So this way we can toggle off certain tasks and say that they are no longer active and they won't be included in this automation. So again, we'll test this action and we will see that they bring back everything correctly. Now we could also add here as a next step, some sort of sorting. We could put these in an order if we wanted to by using the sort list here. For me, I don't really care for this. All I want is to make sure that we create all of those tasks that we found in the template table. But if you need to sort them or put them in some kind of order, you can do that here with the sort list action. Now that we found a list of all the active tasks in our template associated with this group, now we can go in and create them. So we're going to add a repeating group. And we are going to first select the list that we're going to repeat off of. So we select our input list, and it is the find records action that we just took. We're going to use this as a list. Remember, we found four different records, which means that the repeating automation here is going to repeat four times. So for each record that we found, we want to create a record. So every record that we found in our template table, we want to create a record for that in our actual tasks table. And all we want to care about here is the name, right? We want to bring in the name from whatever active template task we found. So we'll bring it in here and we'll say from the current item in the list. Remember, this is going to iterate four times, one time for each task template that we found. So for the record that you're iterating on, I want you to include the name from the task template table. But when we get to the project, it's different. We are not iterating and connecting it to the project based on what we found in our search. We're connecting it to the project that triggered the automation, which meant we need to go back to the record that matches conditions in our automation and plug in that. So this really kind of works through the different layers of the automation. When we are selecting what data to bring in here, we have to know where we had that data earlier in our automation. For us, the project came from the first step, the trigger of the automation. The name of the task we're creating came from the search that we found here. And that's it. All we have to do now is test this automation. But first, we will go ahead and turn it on. And I would strongly recommend that you give it a name as well. So in order to test it and to see it work in real time, what we can do is remove the link here so that it no longer meets the conditions, and then we can reapply the link here. So I'm gonna relink it to task two, and we should start to see tasks getting created right here. So what did the automation do? It looked at the task template and looked for everything that was assigned to group two, right? Which are these four that are active. And then it took tasks D, E, F, and G, those four names, created tasks for them in this table here. We did not sort or put them in any kind of order, but you can. And then it also linked them to the project that initiated the automation, which for us was project one. Let's go ahead and make a change here to these, remove it from the automation, and then re-trigger the automation. This time we'll go with type one. What's it gonna find? Tasks A and B. Why not A, B, and C? Well, C is no longer active. So it's only gonna create tasks A and B. So this is great. We've got our automation working. This is the hard part. Now it's time to build some interfaces. Don't sleep on interfaces. I can't tell you how many times I've worked with clients that have very robust workflows. They have 50 people working in the back end of a database. Interfaces are where you get permissions so that you can share exactly what you want people to see. So here's how we do it. We're gonna build with AI, and I'm just gonna tell Omni, please build a task interface from our task table. And this is the first step. The interface needs to actually bring in the task table that we created as it relates to projects. So if you had things like due dates and assignees and, you know, a status, all of this would look a lot better and cleaner. But for us, it's pretty straightforward, right? We just created tasks for two different projects, so you can see them here. We can also enable it so that we can click into these tasks, as you see, and maybe we edit the name of the task or assign it to somebody or check it off as being complete, or we can collaborate with our team. This is the interface layer that I love, but I want to go deeper than this. This is a good start, but I want another interface as well. So let's close this down, and we're just going to look here at what we've got so far, right? A pretty good interface. Let's go ahead and publish it and see where we're at. So this is a live version of the interface built that quickly. You can see that I've got inline access to edit my different tasks, and I can filter down to a project. I could also have users up here and all kinds of due dates and other things, and I can access all of this. But let's say I want to take this interface to the next level. Again, I have to edit it, so I go back to editing pages, and I can pop open Omni again, and I can say, let's build another interface showcasing our task template table and give the ability to edit the active status. So let's see what Omni puts together. If you haven't used Omni a lot, Omni is the AI builder inside of Airtable. It can also analyze data for us when we are in the actual interface as well, which I love. But for our purposes, we're using it on the back end here. So you can see that a new interface has been created. We can see those that are active and those that are inactive. What I don't love is that it's not showing us the grouping, so I can go in and make these edits. I'll close Omni down and I'll apply a grouping that brings in the template groups, because it's much more valuable for me to see what are the template groups that these different tasks are assigned to from the template. But now for sharing, right? So when I go to share these, I can share access with the appropriate level of people to one or both of these. So if I want to have only admin people with access to the template, then I share this interface with admin. And if I want to have everybody on my team with the ability to see the active tasks, not the template, but the actual tasks that were created, then I share this one with them and not the others. So when I go to share the interface, and I get these questions actually a lot, how do you make sure to share different things? Well, the way that these were built right now by Omni, they were both put in the same interface, it looks like. So we will actually need to open this up and break them into two separate interfaces. This can be a little tricky, so let me walk you through doing this. So we click up here, and you see that this is an interface called interface. And these are two pages within that interface. That's not how I want it, because in order to share it with different audiences, they need to be in their own interfaces. So we're going to create a new interface and we'll name it admin. And then I will copy the, well, in order to create the admin interface, I need to have something in it. So I'll start with a dashboard, which I'm going to delete in a moment. So let's just create this page called dashboard. I'm going to go back to our other interface and I'm going to take the template and duplicate it, but I'm going to duplicate it into the admin space. So it will now exist here. I'll remove the word copy because I don't need it to be a copy, and I can now delete the dashboard. So what we've done now is we've created the task template overview page inside of our admin interface. And I can go into our main interface and we can call this main interface. And I can delete the task template from here. So now when I'm ready to share this interface, first I'll publish all of the interfaces. Let's select them and publish. And then I can share them on an interface level. So I can share the main interface, which is all tasks, and I can share the template overview, which is for the admin users who can create new templates or tasks within the template or deactivate previous ones. And I do this by sharing here, and I choose which interfaces I want to share with whom. So I can only share admin, I can only show the main interface, or I can share both of them at the same time. So that's it, my friends. That is how you build a robust Airtable system using templates to create something like tasks and share it with different types of users in your Airtable setup. I know I went really quickly in this video. There's a lot to cover here, but if you have additional questions that we didn't quite get to, feel free to swing by our website. We put a ton of resources together just for things like this. Of course, if you did get value here, we'd love it if you'd subscribe to the channel, give us a thumbs up, but most importantly, keep on building.